Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video, I'm going to show you how to allocate one or more resources to the tasks in the Gantt chart based on the task requirement. If you have not watched my previous video on how to get started with a React Gantt chart, please do so using the link in the card above or the description below. I will start by opening the existing application where I installed the React Gantt package and have configured all the Gantt chart modules and basic rendering code. You can also find the hierarchical data bound to it that are defined inside the data.js file. Now, I'm going to let you know how to add the resources collection with desired fields to this file. Before looking onto it, see here the left pane as a tree grid with resource data and the right pane as a chart with a project timeline to represent the project duration. Now, let me show you how to add the resources collection with the required fields. Resources are JSON objects that contains ID, name, unit, and a group of resources. This collection needs to be mapped to the Gantt chart control using the resources property. Here, the ID field is used to assign the resource to the task. The name field is used to map the resource names. The unit field is used to indicate the amount of work a resource needs to do in a day. And the group field is used to group the resources and the tasks assigned to that specific resource into the category. In the data.js file, I add the resource details as a JSON collection with two fields, resource ID and resource name. In the resource data variable, let me specify the resource ID and unit fields with the desired values. Here, when the unit is not specified, the amount of work done will be considered 100% by default. On the app.tsx page, I add the resource property to the Gantt code and assign the resource details. I had a column directive here to show the resource details in a separate column. Next, I need to map these resource related fields from the data source to the Gantt chart using the resource info field. At last, the resource fields like ID and name need to be mapped to the Gantt control using the resource fields property. I include ID field and map the resource ID. And then include name option and map the resource name from the resource details. Check the Gantt chart, the resource column is shown in the tree grid and it displays the resource names assigned to the task with units. Let's see how to show resource labels on the Gantt chart. I include the label settings property and assign the resource to the right label option. Looking at it, the resources are shown on the label on the right side of the taskbar. Next, I will show you how to edit the resources assigned to the task. To demonstrate this, I will import edit module from Gantt chart package and inject it in Gantt chart services. To enable the edit settings, I add the edit settings property and enable the allow editing option. Here, I will remove the start date column for the clear visibility of a resources tree grid column. Checking now, when I double click the tree grid cell in the resources column, the dropdown is shown and I can assign more resources or remove the existing one. When I double click the taskbar, the dialog will pop out and under the resources tab, I can add or remove the resources. I can also edit the units here. To edit the resources in the tree grid dialog, I include the mode property and set its value to dialog. When I double click the resources column data, the dialog will be shown and I can edit the details under the resources tab. To add the new task with resource details, I enable the allow adding property in edit settings. To show this option on the toolbar, I will import toolbar module from the Gantt chart package and inject it in the Gantt chart services. Then I include the toolbar property and the option add. Now, when I click the add toolbar button, the dialog pops out with the default values. I will fill in the necessary details under the general and resources tabs. Next, I will show you how to visualize the list of tasks assigned to each resource in a hierarchical manner. To achieve this, I set the resource view option to the view type property in the Gantt chart settings. Look now, you can visualize the list of tasks assigned to each resource hierarchically. A task with no resource assigned comes under the unassigned task category and displays at the bottom of Gantt chart. What if a resource is assigned with two or more tasks scheduled on the same date? We call this overallocation. I enable the show overallocation property to highlight the overallocation date ranges with square brackets. You can see the overallocated tasks are highlighted in square brackets. Here, when I collapse the tree grid records, we cannot visualize multiple tasks assigned to each resource. To overcome this, parent taskbar is divided for each resource by adding the enable multitaskbar property and setting its value to true. Then I map the task name field from the data source to the task label property to show the taskbar label. Check this Gantt chart now. The taskbar is divided based on the tasks assigned to the resource. In this video, I have shown you how to allocate one or more resources to the tasks in the Gantt chart. I also showed you how to view the list of tasks assigned to each resource hierarchically and to enable multiple taskbars. You can download a working example from the GitHub link in the description for this video below. You can also see whether you are eligible for our community license, which will provide you with a free license key to use our products. Thank you for watching this video. If you found it useful, give it a like and subscribe to our channel.